In this video, we'll explore how Excel's new Group By function can instantly summarize sales data, grouping by people, products, years, and more, all with a single dynamic formula instead of a pivot table. Pivot tables are great for interactive reports, but sometimes you want a formula that spills a clean summary right into your sheet, updates dynamically, and can be nested or combined with other formulas. That's what GroupBy does. It's lightweight like some IFs, but groups like a pivot, no field lists, no refresh button. I'm using an example file with a table called SalesData with date, year, salesperson, product, region, units, unit price, and revenue. We'll group by salesperson, product, and revenue, by salesperson, year, and revenue. Sort, filter out rows, and show totals, all from formulas. I go to J1, type equal sign, group by, and open parentheses so you can see the details. Group by takes three required arguments: row fields, what to group by, one column or multiple, values, the numbers you want to aggregate, function, the aggregation to use, like sum, count, average, min, max. Let's see it in action. Our goal, total revenue by salesperson and product. Here's how we get there. For the first argument, highlight the cells in both the salesperson and product columns, including their column headers. Type a comma. For the second argument, highlight the cells in the revenue column, including the column header the way you did before. Type a comma. Then double-click sum from the suggestion list, close parentheses, and press enter. This spills a neat three-column result, each salesperson alongside their product and total revenue. And at the bottom, GroupBy automatically adds a total row at the bottom, so you can see the grand total as well. Let's check the optional arguments. We start from the basic result we've just created and add some optional arguments like field headers, total depth, and sort order. Important, you can only update the group by formula in the cell where you created it initially. In our case, that's J1. Now let's show proper headers by setting up field headers. Click into the formula and add a comma after sum. A little pop-up appears showing the options for field headers. It tells us what each setting means. 0 stands for no headers at all. 1 stands for headers that are included, but don't show them. 2 stands for no headers, but Excel generates generic ones. And 3 stands for headers that are included and show them. Since we want to see salesperson, product, and sum of revenue as headers in the result, we select 3. Press enter, and the headers appear right above the grouped results. Let's continue and add totals and subtotals by setting up total depth. Click into the formula again and add a comma after the 3. Another little pop-up appears, showing the options for total depth. It tells us what each setting means. For multiple row fields, like salesperson and product, it often makes sense to also display subtotals for each salesperson in addition to the grand total. We'll set total depth to 2, which puts the subtotals at the bottom of each group and the grand total at the very end. This way, you can instantly see not only the total per product, but also the combined total per salesperson, and finally, the overall grand total at the bottom. If we set total depth to -2, Excel puts the subtotals at the top of each group and the grand total at the very top. In the next step, let's sort our results by setting the sort order. Click into the formula again and add a comma after 2, the total depth we just set. Unlike before, there's no pop-up menu here. You just have to type the number directly. How it works. In the formula syntax, the sort index numbers the columns in the order they appear. 1 refers to salesperson, our first row field. 2 refers to product, our second row field. 3 refers to revenue, our value. So when you type -3, you're telling Excel, sort by the third argument in my formula, which is revenue, in descending order. And when you type just 3, you're telling Excel, sort by the third argument in my formula, which is revenue, in ascending order. So if you add a minus before the number, you flip the sort order. Notice that totals are always excluded from sorting. They stay fixed at the top or bottom depending on your total depth setting. Also good to know, you don't have to fill in every argument one by one. If you only want to change a later argument, you can leave the earlier ones empty. Just make sure to keep the commas in place. For example, if you want to jump straight to sort order but leave field headers and total depth at their defaults, you would write 3 commas after sum and add the -3 after the third comma. The 3 empty commas tell Excel, Skip these arguments, go directly to the next one. Finally, let's select specific rows. So we filter inside the formula by using filter arrays. We're still editing the formula in J1. Click into the formula again and add a comma after -3 to reach the next optional argument, filter array. Here you enter a true/false test. Only rows where the test is true will be included in the summary. I've prepared three examples. Example 1, select only a specific salesperson called Olivia Rossi. Highlight the cells in the salesperson column including the header. After that, type equals sign and Olivia Rossi after. The name has to be in quotation marks. The formula checks every row in the salesperson column. If the row is Olivia Rossi, it returns true. All other names return false. Only Olivia's rows make it into the group by result. Example 2, select only a certain product, the mouse. Now we are changing the filter array to the product column. Highlight the cells in the product column, including the header. Type equals sign and mouse after. The product has to be in quotation marks. Excel checks every row in the product column. If the product is mouse, the row is true and included. Everything else is false and excluded. Example 3. Select a mouse revenue above 10,000. We are changing the filter array again. This time we open parentheses first. Highlight the product column including the header. Type equals sign and mouse after. Don't forget that the mouse has to be in quotation marks and close parentheses. Add asterisk, which works as and. Open parentheses. Highlight the revenue column, including the header. Type greater than 10,000. Add two closing parentheses and press enter. This means only rows where the product is mouse and the revenue is greater than 10,000 will be included. The grouped result will show totals only for those larger mouse sales. Important: the condition revenue greater than 10,000 checks each individual row in the data table. It only includes a row if that single revenue value is above 10,000. It does not filter based on the grouped sum of revenue. The filtering happens before the grouping. Now let's group by year and salesperson. Click into J1 and start typing equals sign, followed by group by and open parentheses. Now select the columns. In this case, year and salesperson for the row field and revenue for the value. Select sum and add the setup for headers, which is 3 for totals, which is 2, and for sorting, which is -3. Close parentheses and press enter. This spills a tidy 3-column summary. Year, salesperson, revenue, with subtotals per year, a grand total at the bottom, and all in descending order. Now you have a live leaderboard. If a big sale is added, the order updates automatically. No manual sorting needed. Let's exclude unwanted rows next by excluding blanks. Sometimes your table has blank rows in between. Let me add a few on the fly. Then we'll create a new formula using a filter array to exclude them. This works with any column, as long as the whole row is empty. Here's how it works. Click in J1 and type equals sign, followed by group by and open parentheses. Highlight the salesperson column including its header. Highlight the revenue column including its header. Select sum, put a 3 after, close parentheses, and press enter. If you press enter now, while the data table still contains empty rows, those blanks will also be included in the grouping. So you'll see an extra row in the result with an empty salesperson and a revenue sum of 0. Here's how to fix it. Click back into the formula in J1. After 3, add 3 commas until you reach the filter array argument. Now highlight the salesperson column including its header and type smaller than greater than, followed by 2 quotation marks and press enter. This tells Excel, only include rows where the salesperson is not blank. Now the grouped summary updates and the empty rows are excluded. Let's wrap up. That's group by, a single formula that gives you instant summaries directly in your sheet, compared to a pivot table. We grouped by salesperson and product without building field lists. We added headers, subtotals, and grand totals just by setting arguments. We sorted dynamically. No need to resort manually after updates. We filtered rows inside the formula itself, like keeping only Olivia Rossi or mouse sales above 10,000. We compared salesperson performance by year with one formula instead of building a new pivot each time. And we excluded blank rows on the fly. All of this happens live, updates automatically with new data, and nests easily inside other formulas. With group by, you get pivot style power, but in the flexibility of a formula. If you enjoyed this, hit subscribe for more Excel tips. And as always, happy excelling.